Hello there, good evening. Welcome to Look North, our top story tonight. Campaigning for better access, the terminally ill Whitby man who won't give up on his fight for equality.
Makes me angry, frustrated. It shouldn't be like this.
We'll ask a disability rights expert why it's left to people like Ian to champion these issues. I hope you're well this evening. A grandfather from Whitby is fighting for better access for people with disabilities in North Yorkshire. Now, Ian Lawson was diagnosed with motor neurone disease 10 years ago and he relies on his wheelchair. He contacted us here at Look North, telling us that many restaurants and other venues in Whitby and Scarborough just don't have any disabled access. Last year, he won a discrimination case after one restaurant removed an accessible lift, but he's finding it difficult to fund any further cases. Carla Fowler has been to meet him.
Ian Lawson is living with motor neurone disease, and in a town like Whitby, that's a challenge. The old building stock and cobblestones make life difficult, especially for wheelchair users. The choice of accessible venues is limited. This large restaurant occupies a prime tourist spot in a council-owned building. It was recently refurbished by new tenants with no disabled access included. Ian complained and even alerted the council, but nothing changed. So last year he took the tenant to court and succeeded in a claim of discrimination.
Before it was refurbished, they had us there lived. When the building inspectors signed it up, they didn't check on disabled access, which they should have done.
Local authorities should make reasonable adjustments to remove barriers to disabled people under the Equality Act. The council owns around 1,800 properties across the borough, but it isn't responsible for enforcing the Act.
With no legal aid for me to take action, so I run the risk if I lose of paying all the costs involved. Hello there, I would like to book a wheelchair accessible taxi, please.
Ian's trying to get a taxi home, calling from the offices of Whitby Disabled Action Group.
You don't have one.
He's called eight companies so far.
Across the borough, I think there are about six accessible taxis. In Whitby, we have two. So the chances of somebody getting one are very slim. What we need is for disabled people to shout loud.
We asked Scarborough Borough Council for an interview and they provided a statement saying, "We agree that the proportion of wheelchair accessible taxis in our borough needs to be higher. We are committed to reducing inequalities. We care about equal access for disabled people and look to continually improve our understanding of their needs." But it needn't take huge changes to improve access. At this Whitby restaurant, a bell has been installed at wheelchair height outside, and a ramp can be brought out when needed.
Disabled access, it's trying to appeal to another market as well, the market of people who want to use our business. It would be a detriment if we didn't have it. We see it as a real positivity, and it's brought us a lot of trade this summer.
We asked the owners of Abbey Wharf restaurant for an interview, but they declined. They did say they were doing everything in their power to rectify the situation and a lift will be installed.
Makes me anxious, makes me angry, frustrated. It shouldn't be like this.
It certainly shouldn't, should it? Fazile Hadi is from the Disability Rights UK. I asked her how common the problems that Ian raises are.
It's really unfortunate, but they are so common and they just shouldn't be in 2021. But everyday challenges, as you say, as Ian is experiencing, getting out and about, meeting friends, going out for a meal, all these things that everyone takes for granted can still be really difficult and challenging for disabled people, and they just shouldn't be.
How is it that these buildings without disability access get signed off?
I'm absolutely incredulous that that can happen. The Disability Discrimination Act was passed in 1995, so that's 26 years ago. And it was superseded by something called the Equality Act, but basically the provisions are the same. which is that all service providers and employers have to make reasonable adjustments for disabled people. And not only that, they have to think in advance if they're planning something. And local authorities have particular duties under law to make sure that their citizens are treated equally.
As we've seen there from Ian's video, it's clearly not happening in many places. Why is it left to people like Ian to champion this and to shout out about it?
Well, you know, huge thanks to Ian. But really, as you infer, it shouldn't be the job of disabled people to make society accessible and inclusive for us all.
So who should it be down to? Who should be making these decisions to make sure it is equal for everyone?
I think it should be the institutions like government, like local government, like inspectorates. There should be proper enforcement under the Equality Act. Just like we have trading standards, we have environmental health, we really need inspectorate that really takes responsibility and holds service providers, government to account when they don't include us as disabled people.
Just very briefly, anyone who's in Ian's situation, what should they do?
Exactly what Ian's done, draw attention to it, make a complaint, tell the right authorities and tell the media as well.
Thank you for your time.
Thank you.